Hello everyone! In this short video, I'm going to show you how to do Bulgarian cast on. Why I'm doing it? Because my next project is knitting a trendy balaclava where I will use this method. The Bulgarian cast on is very stretchy and suits well for balaclavas, hats and socks. Basically for everything that requires an elastic edge. First, I show how to cast on the left hand. Mainly I use only two fingers to cast on, three others hold the working thread. The loose end is closer to me and I take about four lengths of thread. I take my needle and do two first loops. I do a movement up to pick up the thread in the middle, then pick up the line which is closer to me. Next one is the line from the pointer finger. And insert the needle into the loop on my thumb finger. I tighten it up and get two first stitches. One of the stitches I will use to join the circle. Now you see how the thread on my thumb fingers look like. It wraps it around and crosses in the center. To make the next loop, I need to place the thread another way so threads don't cross each other. Now I pick up the thread that is farther from me. Then pick up the thread from the pointer finger and insert the needle into the loop here. Tighten it up. Here I can see something like the stretch I made now. The next stitch is a classic one. Now the thread on my thumb is crossed again. I pick up the thread closer to me, then the thread from the pointer finger and finally to the loop again. Tighten it up. I'm going to alternate that and these stitches until I reach the needed number of stitches. First, the stitch where the thread is not crossed on my thumb. Here I pick up the thread kind of from inside of the whole construction. Second, I pick up the thread outside using the thread closer to me. The difference is only how the thread is placed initially, because the rest of the movements are the same. While casting on, I also see the chain along the edge. If you get a chain like this, you do everything right. And of course, you can check how stretchy it is. I see many use left hand for casting on, but for me, right hand is more convenient. Therefore, I want to show you it once more on my right hand. First, I do a movement up to pick up the thread in the middle. Then pick up the line which is closest to me. Next one is the line from the pointer finger. And I move the needle in between here on my thumb finger. I tighten it up and get two first stitches. The thread on my thumb finger looks like I'm going through a classic cast on. It wraps it around and crosses in the center. To make the next loop, I need to place the thread another way so threads don't cross each other. Now I pick up the thread from the middle, then pick up the thread from the pointer finger and insert the needle into the loop here. Tighten it up. The next stitch is a classic one. I pick up the thread closer to me, then the thread from the pointer finger and finally to the loop again. Tighten it up. Now, whatever the hand you're using on, I'm sure you will manage to cast on all stitches. When all stitches on my needle, I can actually see that they are paired. I know therefore I cast on correctly. To join the circle, I used the very first stitch, therefore I counted the needed number of stitches plus one. I move it to the right needle and move over the last stitch. Then I need to tighten the thread and make a knot here. If you do stockinette knitting, then remember while counting on the stitches that in the beginning you had a double stitch. Right after, I can keep on doing my knitting. It can be rib, it can be plain knitting, or whatever pattern I have. Here you can see how the Bulgarian cast on stretches after some rows of knitting. I hope you find this video helpful and useful for your projects. Thank you for watching and see you soon in my new video.